Hi, welcome here. Let's see quickly how to use Photoshop Elements 13. Leave us feedback if you find mistakes. Check out the video description for the index of all that is explained here. In short, Photoshop Elements can be seen as a mix between Adobe Photoshop and Adobe Lightroom. It collects some of the photography features and some functions related to vectors and graphic manipulation. When you open the software, a dialog box lets you choose between Organizer and Photo Editor. Organizer is used to manage and categorize your photos. We won't see it in this video. We will focus on the Photo Editor, which is Photoshop Elements itself. New in the 13th version is the eLive tab. This is a direct connection to what Adobe offers you on this software, from video tutorials to suggestions. Check it out. Then you have three main workspaces. Quick mode is perfect to retouch photos without going too much in detail. Guided goes a little more in detail, treating photos more professionally. The Expert workspace gives you full control on each single pixel of the photo and contains some features of Adobe Photoshop. If you want to go straight to the Expert mode, watch the video in this guide. We will start with the Quick mode. To add photos, simply drag your file on the workspace. You can also add more of them, but you can view just one photo per time. To change the photo to edit, click on the Photo Bin button in the bottom left corner and double-click on the file interested. You can click again on Photo Bin to hide the list. You have some important tools here below. You can zoom in out the photo using your mouse wheel while holding Alt down. When the picture is big, hold Space down to enable the Hand tool to move. Then you have the Undo and Redo buttons, used to manage your actions done. The Rotate button is used to rotate the photo, whereas Organizer opens Adobe Elements Organizer 13. You also have the Tool Options button. This simply contains all options of any tool that is enabled. You will also notice a small after in a corner. This means that the software is showing you the photo after all your modifications. In the top left corner, on View, you can choose what to show. After is with the modifications, before how the photo was originally. Let's see quickly how to adjust a photo. You have two groups of tools, the quick ones on the left and the adjustments on the right. After adjusting the photo with Rotate, you may need to cut parts of the photo you don't want. So activate the Crop tool on the left and click and drag to select the parts of the photo you want to save. Then you can edit this selection area as you like. Drag it to move, use the corners to scale, and drag from outside to rotate. You can also choose Ready templates at the bottom, on Tool Options. Then just apply with the green button. Remember to use the Undo button to cancel the crop done. Then you have to adjust the aspect of the photo. You can use Smart Fix on the right to pick ready adjustments. You can hover on the templates at the bottom to check how the photo will be. Click to apply or use the bar on top. If this is not enough, go to the Options, more at the bottom. Use Exposure and Lighting to adjust contrast. and brightness. Moreover, lighting lets you edit differently both darker and lighter parts of the image. Then you need to adjust the color, so go to Color and to Balance to set hue, saturation and tint. When the photo is OK, you can still enhance it. Use Sharpen to add clarity to the picture. Use the Red Eye Removal tool to remove red eyes from photos. Just include the whole eye inside the rectangle. Use Whiten Teeth to improve people's teeth. In any of these tools on the left, you can adjust options at the bottom, as always. After all these changes, you can see with After and Before the difference the Photoshop elements can make on a picture. There are other important tools in this software. Quick Selection tool selects just parts of the image. Just click and drag. Remember, if you have any selected area up, the adjustments will act just on such area instead of the full photo. While this selection tool is on, press Escape key to remove the selection. Then you have the text tools. Choose at the bottom font, size, style, and also the kind of text tool. There are the horizontal and vertical tools to type in such manners. But there are also the mask text tools that are able to make selection with the shape of the selected text. Check them. All of them work in the same way. Just click and drag to define a text area and then type in. Always make sure that the area is big enough, otherwise you won't be able to see all text inside. Just drag the notes to resize it. If you hold Ctrl down instead, you will resize the area but also the text inside. Also, hold Ctrl down and drag to move text fast and rotate it, dragging from outside. Then just apply. The area can be edited easily also after applying. There are also the Healing Brush tools, which are used to hide unwanted objects. If you are interested in this tool, watch the next video in this guide. You don't have just the adjustments on the right. In the bottom right corner, you can select effects to apply ready-made effects on the photo. Just select one. You can also add textures and frames. Check them. Let's see now the guided workspace. This works almost in the same way as seen in the quick mode, indeed. What changes is what you have on the right. These different categories collect very professional photo adjustments. So let's see how it works. First of all, use the rotate button at the bottom if you need. Then you must improve the photo, and this is made by the touch-ups section. Start cropping the photo using Crop Photo. This works in the same way seen before. Have a look at how is this workspace. Every time you enable a tool, its options appear on the right, and to confirm, just click on Done below. To come back and undo all, click on Cancel. To improve lightness and contrast, you can use the first tool, and Lighten and Darken, which is equal to lighting seen before. Then you need to adjust hue and saturation using Enhance Colors. After that, reduce noise and smoothness using Sharpen. Plus, you have many other tools quite professional. These are guided, which means that, on the right, the software helps you with different steps and instructions that do include specific tools to be used, for example, restore old photo. In case you are a beginner, it can be very useful using Perfect Portrait to enhance people's photos. This is completely guided, listing you even the order of the tools to be used. Check it out. At this point, your photo will be much better than before, but you can try photo effects and camera effects sections if you want to apply effects on it. These are fully guided as well, just follow the list and the tools suggested. Photoplay collects other kinds of effects that do change more the aspect of your photo. Once your photo is ready, you have to export it. There are different ways to do so. You can use the Create button in the top right corner to export your picture to print it, make calendars, labels, and even slideshows. You can use Share to export it on the web and social networks. If you want to save the picture on your computer, just go to File and then to Save As. As long as you use the Quick or the Guided workspace, you can choose to save the picture as .jpg or .png. It is the same. This is all. If you want to discover the Expert workspace, watch the next video in this guide.